Hi students, how are you all? Hope you all fine and safe. I believe that you all understood what I taught in the last video. Today we are going to continue the lesson from where I stopped. Before that, I wish to give one small recap from which I taught last session. Shall we start? Yes. The first question, what is history? Very good. History is a recorded document of past, isn't it? That too in chronological order. Very good. From which language we got the word history? Greek language. Very good. What is the meaning of the word? Learning by enquiry. Very good. How Indian history has been classified? Very good. Indian history has been classified into Asian period, medieval period, and modern period. Very good. What are the two types of sources available for us to know about history? Primary sources and secondary sources. Very good. In last class, what are the two sources we learnt? From the primary sources, we learnt about inscriptions and monuments, isn't it? What is the third sources? Coins. Very good. So now today we are going to learn about coins. Okay, look at the coin, children. I think you all know this is our 5 rupees coin, isn't it? Can you tell me what and all the information can you get from this coin? In this coin we are having our lion emblem, that is our Indian government emblem, and below that our Indian government motto Satyameva Jayate, and the name of the country India written in Hindi as well as English. That means these two languages are the official languages of India, isn't it? And the backside of the coin, we are having the value of that coin and also the year which this coin was introduced, isn't it? So these many informations we are getting from this coin, isn't it? Imagine a person going to see this coin after 100 years may get these information from this coin, isn't it? Like that, the coin released by the rulers before hundreds or thousands of years ago can give so many informations about their kingdom, isn't it? That only we are going to learn now. Okay, the study of coins is known as numismatics. The study of coin means we should know what and all the information they are inscribed on that coin. No, for that we should study about that coin. That study is known as numismatics. Not only study, some people are having habit of collecting the coins. That also known as numismatics. Okay, next. First point, listen carefully children, I am going to read the lines. Okay, the pictures on the coins convey the names of kings with their titles and portraits, events, places, dates, dynasties and logos. So if the king introduced one coin, means in that coin the king inscribed his name with his title and his portrait. Portrait means uruva padamnu solluvaangalaya, adha and the king oda image. And events, if the coin released in remembrance of some events, that events also inscribed in that coin. Places, the place where the coin released, and date, when the coin was released. And dynasties, dynasties means Raja Vamsam solluvom illaya, and the vamsathoda pair. And logos, logos mean or adayala chinnam illaya. For all the kings, they are having logos. They inscribe that logo also in that in their coins. So if we get one coin, from that coin we can understand the name and title of the king who released and his image and when and where he released that coin and name of their dynasties and about their logos. These things we can get from this coin. The second point is the composition of metals in the coins gives us information on the economic condition of the empire. So composition of metals means if you want to make one coin means we have to made it using some metals, isn't it? Which metal they are used to made that coin tells the economic condition of the empire. We all know the different types of metals. For example, I am saying gold means it is having more value and silver means its value is lesser than gold. And if you are taken copper means it's very much lesser than gold, isn't it? So these are the different types of metals used to made coins. Okay, from the value of these metals we can get the information of economic condition of the empire. Economic condition means how wealthy the king was. Okay, the next point is mention of king's achievements like military conquest, territorial expansion, trade links and religious faith also found in the coins. So king's achievements na enadhu sadhanigal. What are the achievements of a king? Getting victory by the military movement and territorial expansion to spread his kingdom. Okay, if he got victory means what he will do? He will annex the lands which he conquered. That is called territorial expansion. And then trade links means business dealings. And religious faith, that is the belief on God, also found in the coins. The next point is Mohammad Ghori, who is the invader of Turkey, had stamped the figure of goddess Lakshmi on his gold coins and had his name inscribed on it. From that, we can understand that the Turkish invader was liberal in his religious outlook. What name I mentioned here first? Mohammad Ghori. Very good. Who is he? He is the invader of Turkey. Invader means படையெடுப்பாளர் சொல்லுவாங்க. ஒரு நாட்டிலிருந்து இன்னொரு நாட்டுக்கு படையெடுத்து வருவாங்க இல்லையா, அவங்கள தான் இன்வேடர்னு சொல்கிறாங்க. வாட் ஹி டிட் மீன்ஸ் ஹீ ஹேட் ஸ்டாம்ப்டு த ஃபிகர் ஆஃப் காடஸ் லக்ஷ்மி ஆன் இஸ் கோல்டு காயின் அண்ட் ஆல்சோ ஹீ இன்ஸ்கிரைப்டு ஹிஸ் நேம் ஆன் இட். ஆக்சுவலி ஹீ இஸ் அ இஸ்லாமிக் இன்வேடர், இசன்ட் இட்? பட் ஹீ இன்ஸ்கிரைப்டு த ஃபிகர் ஆஃப் காடஸ் லக்ஷ்மி ஆன் இஸ் கோல்டு காயின். ஸோ ஃப்ரம் தட் வாட் யூ கேன் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட், திஸ் டர்கிஷ் இன்வேடர் வாஸ் லிபரல் இன் இஸ் ரிலீஜியஸ் அவுட்லுக். தட் மீன்ஸ் ஹீ கிவ்ஸ் ஈக்குவல் இம்பார்ட்டன்ஸ் டு ஆல் ரிலீஜியன்ஸ். ஓகே, வெரி குட். த நெக்ஸ்ட் பாயிண்ட் இஸ் காப்பர் ஜிட்டல்ஸ் அண்ட் சில்வர் டங்கா விச் வேர் இன்ட்ரடியூஸ்ட் பை இல்துமிஷ் கேவ் மோர் இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் அபவுட் டெல்லி சுல்தான்ஸ். லுக் அட் த பிக்சர் சில்ட்ரன். தி ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் காப்பர் ஜிட்டல் and second one is silver danka. These coins were introduced by Iltutmish. Iltutmish was a Delhi sultan. Look at the coin children. In these they are written so many letters in these coins. These letters are the rich information about the Delhi sultans. Okay, a jital contains 3.6 grains of silver. So 48 jitals were equal to 1 silver danka. For example, I am saying if you are having 1 rupee coin means actually it is a 100 paise, isn't it? 100 paisa is equal to 1 rupee. Like that, 48 jitals were equal to 1 silver danga. So, one jital contains 3.6 grains of silver. Okay, fine. This jital and the danga is very important. In your book bag question, this question also they asked. Okay, so listen carefully and look at the picture children. This is the Alauddin Khilji's gold coin. See how many letters they are written inside that coin. So these are the rich sources of information. And the next one is Mohammed bin Tughlaq's copper token currency. Okay, these currencies are indicative of coinage as well as the economic prosperity of the country. Okay, so today what we learned? We learned about coins. What and all the information we are getting from the coins also we learned. Okay, this is your worksheet. I am going to read the worksheet. Listen carefully. Roman number 1, fill in the blanks. First question. Dash had stamped the figure of Goddess Lakshmi on his gold coins and had his name inscribed on it. And the second question, 3.6 grains of silver amounted to a dash. Okay, I told you this question will come in the book back exercise. So you just recall it. Okay, next match the following. Actually, this is based on your first video. Khajuraho. Khajuraho is the temple in Madhya Pradesh. And next one is Konark. Konark is the sun temple. It is there in Odisha. And third one is Dilwara. Dilwara is in Rajasthan. Next one is Virupaksha. Virupaksha is there in Hampi. Okay. And then third Roman number. Match the statement with the reason. Assertion and reason. They will give one sentence and also they will give the reason. If the assertion is correctly suitable for that reason, means you can give the answer or is the correct explanation of A. If or is not correct explanation of A, you can select B. And A is wrong and R is correct means you can select C. And A and R wrong means you can select D. That is called assertion and reasoning. Okay. First question, I am going to read this. Mohammed Ghori's gold coins carried the figure of Goddess Lakshmi. I told you, no, Mohammed Ghori is the invader from Turkey. He inscribed the figure of Goddess Lakshmi in his gold coin. The reason is the Turkish invader was liberal in his religious outlook. That means he gave equal importance to all the religion, isn't it? So that is the correct reason also. So assertion and that reason also is correct. So R is the correct explanation of A. So A is the correct answer. And fourth Roman number, answer the following. The question is, describe the different types of coins introduced by the rulers of Delhi Sultanate. So you have to write the coins, different types of coins released in the Delhi Sultan period. Okay, you have to write these answers in your note. After that, you have to write the home test. Okay, already I told you in the first video, whatever worksheet I am giving, that you have to write it in your note one time. And also you have to read that and then you have to write the home test. Okay, clear children? Thank you for watching this video and thank you. Bye.